Hey, are you struggling to understand the difference or how to even use these ancient machines in the DLC, A Rift in Time? Well, don't fret. I'm here to help you out today. I am back with another tip and trick to help you out with your Disney Dreamlight Valley. Now, come along for the ride and let me show you all the new stuff. Obviously, if you've had the DLC since it released in December of 2023, none of this information might be new to you, but you might still be somewhat confused on the difference between each of the machines versus the basic, regular, and advanced of each one, right? We were given a vacuum, a gardener, as well as cookers. And they're three fantastic machines that do wonderful things, but they do it in different ways depending on the level that you have. Now, first and foremost, before we even get into this, one of the basic parameters that you have to have in order to take advantage or use any of these machines is to have the DLC, A Rift in Time. You will need that in order for you to see or use or do any of this. So if you haven't done that yet, go ahead and don't worry about watching the rest of this video. Come back once you do, and then feel free to sit by and get the rest of this explanation. Now let's move forward and say that you do have the game and you've either are brand new to it or you've had it for a while and you just don't really know what to do. When you get into the DLC, not only do you get new characters, a new map, and you also get a new tool, but you will also receive new items and furniture pieces, as well as ancient machines. And I love these ancient machines. They make it such a relief when you log on and if you are crunched on time or if you just want to be able to focus on other things. Now, all of these things do require the new currency, which would be Mist. Mist is the equivalent of what Dreamlight Valley points were. It's the same thing. It's just that it's the currency for this area, the DLC. Now, you're still going to do Dreamlight points elsewhere on your regular valley and usually for a lot of the main game stuff. However, anything DLC related, anything with the ancient machines, they are going to use Mist. Easy way to do Mist is when you're here on the island, you can just do these, you know, just like on the other regular island, it refreshes and recycles so you can do stuff over and over again. But they also have their own tag for Eternity Isle as well. And as annoying as it is, this and finishing these are extremely helpful in gaining as many Mist points as you need. Obviously, having many Mist buddies with you, going around and cleaning up the island and using your wand and having them follow you is also a wonderful way to gain Mist as well. So in whatever method and whatever fashion you choose to get your Mist, just know that is the currency that you're going to need in order to use and activate any of these machines. Now, when you move onto the island, you're going to be introduced to a plethora of quests and characters and all of that. But when you get to the point that you can interact with this time-bending table, which is the newer table, similar to the crafting one that came from Disney Dreamlight Valley, I want you to interact with it and look at two main buttons. The first button is going to be your most important, your upgrade hourglass button. It's quite big, it's hard to miss, but it is right at the top. When you click on this, yours might say something different. It might have level 1, 2, 3, just depending on when you last looked at it. Whatever the case is, you're going to see not only a different level above it, but something underneath it that's going to allow you to press to activate it. It's going to need you to have specific items that you can use your hourglass to be able to locate and find. These aren't difficult to find, but they can be just annoying to try to gather. It'll ask you for simple things like an ancient belt or magnet or plate or radiator, gear. It's things like that. Now, once you've upgraded your wand, and at least to a level 1, you will now be able to locate ancient cores level 1. I know that seems kind of redundant, but a lot of people weren't aware of this. When you go around and you're looking for an ancient core level 2 or an ancient core level 3, you're not going to be able to locate them unless your time wand is at the level that you are looking for or above it. Don't fret if you go ahead and upgrade your time wand like I did all the way up to level 4. That doesn't mean you're going to miss out on getting any ancient cores at level 1 or level 2 or level 3 because you're suddenly surpassed it. That would be silly. Now you can just easily find any and all of them because your wand is capable of doing so. So that's the first thing you really, really want to make sure that you note. Once you have your cores down and you have your time wand fully upgraded, now let's look at the machines. Okay, we're going to go back. The second button I want you to look at is the ancient machine button. This is going to show you the three basic versions of the three new machines that we get to take advantage of. Now, they're amazing as they are. I'm not going to say that they aren't. They're definitely still doing a job, but the name gives it away. They're pretty basic. It is what it is. It's very just simplified. Here's this new machine. Get to kind of know it. But as you upgrade the machine, it gets better. I will say advanced is just as the name states, it is the best. It is advanced. It does the most, and you can get the most bang for your buck. However, not everybody is going to get up to that point right away, so I will show you the difference today between the three, and you can decide which one you want to chase for right off the bat and which one you just kind of want to coast for until you naturally have the materials and you don't feel like you're grinding. I do want to make a big point to show, when you've made and crafted each of the basic versions of these, you need to keep them in your pocket in order to upgrade them to the next level. You can certainly get out of your main menu, lay them down, and use them as needed, and then put them back in your pocket in order to upgrade them later if needed. However, just know that you will need them in order to upgrade to the next one. And I'll just show you simply, if I was to make a basic ancient cooker, it just requires me to have 2 level 1 cores, 3 ancient radiators, and 3 ancient plates, right? And some mist. So of course, all of these things we've gone over on how to obtain them. Anything ancient related you can find on the OG Valley or the DLC. So you should be able to just use your wand anywhere and everywhere inside the White Spheres, as well as just running around into each biome. Those will just naturally pop up as you go along. Make sure to take a time buddy with you so that you can get at least double the items. But you can see here, once I've crafted it, if I wanted to then take the basic ancient cooker and I wanted to make it a regular ancient cooker, I would need to have had a basic ancient cooker already made and put away in my pocket. Imagine that you're upgrading the machine that you've already made. You're putting in newer parts. You can't just pull it out of thin air. It has to have already been made. So the same thing would go for the regular ancient cooker, making it move on to the regular or advanced ancient cooker. And in, as you can see, this has all the same stuff except for the cores do change. They go up per level. And now has the regular ancient cooker missing at the bottom. So as long as I was to make one of these and then craft another of the regular, I could then craft another advanced ancient cooker. Now, I went ahead and made all 3 of each of them so that you can see the difference, just because they can be just kind of silly. And I feel like if you don't have the right level, a lot of people feel like they're broken or they're not working. And that's not the case. They just might be misinformed or just had no idea. So let me show you the difference. Here at the gardeners, this is probably one of my favorites as far as the simplicity of the gardener itself. It can water for free, does not require mist to water, which is a lovely feature, a lovely aspect. A lot of people will grab it and move one of these to go above crops that they want watered without having to run over there with their watering cans. They can avoid using any energy, which is fantastic. And the nice thing with the watering portion is it does not use mist, like I said in the beginning. So it's a free method that you could take advantage of with this machine. And a lot of us have done that as of recent. Now, I do want you to notice when I'm holding it, you can see the difference between the small, the medium, and the large. It is quite literally just the amount of space that it covers. And then when you go up to it, you can also see that it requires or offers multiple different jobs. The smaller one, it's going to dig up to 15 spots. I can have it dig 15 and at times 10 of mist. It'll use 150 mist out of my 44.8. That'll dig the small section, and then I can select the seeds that I may or may not have in my pocket, and then I can also plant them for an additional amount of mist. Now, I can plant by myself if I wanted to. I could use this just to simply dig. In either scenario, it's really up to you and what works best. But just know the difference between the three is simply the size that it gives you, the parameter it gives you. So the first one was 15. This one is 24. And then this one should be...
Bonjour. Hope to see you soon.
35. So you just get more space, which covers a wider area. And really, I feel like small, medium, or large in the ancient gardeners are pretty much amazing as they are. There's not much that I have to ever think about. You can certainly just keep moving this over and over and over again to harvest for you. That's another thing I forgot to mention. As you can see here, it will harvest for you if you would like. I do want to warn you, although the harvester will allow you to pull memories and those things that'll kind of usually pop up by itself without worry, it will not give you extras if you have a buddy. So if you were to take a gardening buddy and you were to be a person that loves to do the pineapples or whatever to make your money, if you use a machine, that is your assistant. That instead of having a buddy, it's not as if you don't have a buddy with you, but if you have a buddy with you and you use the machine, they didn't assist with you, so you're not going to get any of the bonuses. So if you're confused by what I mean by that, if you have a buddy that runs around with you on the island and you go to harvest something and that's their job, they usually will dig on the ground and pull up an extra one or two or however many crops alongside the same crops that you are growing. So you can get double or triple the amount depending on the extras and the golden stuff, right? But the machines, however, they make it easy and nice, they do not allow you to do that. So be aware that when you do use the machines, it allows you that ease of use, and you can be lazy with it, but that also means that you can't get and take advantage of having a buddy with you. Okay, so I feel the gardeners are pretty easy to understand. Let's move on to one of the most important ones, the vacuum. The vacuum to me is the most annoying because a lot of people don't understand or didn't understand the difference between level 1, 2, and 3. And it can be quite jarring to know the difference. So the first one, level 1 is only going to find ephemerals. If you don't know what an ephemeral is, it is this. These spiky rocks. Now, if you're confused because you're like, I don't really know that name. I knew of those as the DLC Night Thorns. That is the exact same thing. So if I took this and I went back to my OG Valley and I had any Night Thorns left, if I put this in the biome with the Night Thorns, you would see only the Night Thorns appear. So ephemerals and Night Thorns are the only thing that the level 1 will pick up. And that's a lovely feature and trait, but I could also go and pick those up. So it's not really worth it to me. Now, level 2 does a little more. As you can see, not only does it pick up the original ephemerals, but it also picks up wild crops and flowers. Now, wild crops can be quite literally anything that's wild. This could be garlic, this could be vanilla on the OG island. Then you can also come to this island and it can be cumin and anything else that grows, bamboo, whatever wild crop is growing in the ground. And then, of course, flowers, that's pretty much in the name. Any of the flowers that happen to be on the ground, it can also appear and pick up as well. Now, the third one is the best one. I know the name should have given it away, advanced vacuum, but it is the best. Not only will it pick up anything that I mentioned before, ephemerals or night thorns, wild crops like garlic or cumin, but flowers, as well as any other items I may have dropped and not picked up. So, for example, we just had a button event take place, and one of the most obnoxious things to find was the red button, because it could end up appearing underneath rugs, it could appear underneath a bush, too close to a house. You know, if you don't get too close to it, you can't see the little golden sparkly things to draw your eye to it. But the way to get around this was if you had an ancient vacuum at level 3, you could easily use it and then find the button that was hidden somewhere in the realm, somewhere in the valley. And it makes it so nice and so easy to take care of. So if you were in the boat, especially for this last few weeks where that was that special event. Just thinking back, the Easter egg event was another one. I was finding Easter eggs for months after it ended. But this would have easily taken care of it. One of the things I would say, or I want to warn people about, is it does use a lot of mist. So be careful that you're kind of keeping an eye on how much mist it's using. It should tell you down at the bottom. But also, if you decorate with anything, I just so happen to decorate with crystals from the Crystallis Mines, and I lay them down individually. Well, if I use this machine, although I can have it select all, I can deselect anything that I might want to keep on the ground. There might be items specifically I use to decorate, and I don't want it to pick it all back up, because then I gotta go lay it all back down again. So don't be like me and mistakenly pick up everything. Definitely pay attention to what you're grabbing. But the nicety is you do have a select all button. You can deselect if necessary. But level 3 is the best as far as it comes to the vacuum. So if you can get up to the level 3, I guarantee you'll enjoy it a lot. Now, last but not least, we have the cookers. Now, the 3 big differences in these cookers is not time. It is just space. The easiest thing for me to show you is just to physically put in each one of these. I'm going to give you an idea of how much you can do per. I'm just going to cook one thing so I can show you. So the smaller one, you can only cook up to 10. The medium one should be double that. So the medium one should be 20. I'm going to do this. And unfortunately, you can't hit the back arrow and make it go all the way to the end, which would be pretty nice. But that does 20. And then here, We're going to do one more. This one should do 30. Now, I wanted to make a point to say that each of these takes 30 minutes in order to finish the meals. It doesn't matter if it has 10 meals, 20 meals, or 30 meals. It has a 30-minute marker. So you can cook, leave, run away, do your own thing, and then when it is done, it is ready. It'll be turned off. So you can kind of see these are turned on right now. I have one that I used earlier up here, just for example. As you can see, it's turned off. There's nothing on it. But if I was to interact with it, you can see here, it finished all the meals that I needed. So all I need to do is claim it, grab it, and I'm good to go. So it is a wonderful, wonderful tool to use, especially if you are somebody that likes to be able to make multiple meals at once. A lot of people were using it, for example, bringing back to the button event that took place. A lot of people used it for the button event when we had to make a bunch of the cupcakes. It just made it a lot easier. We didn't have to deal with it as much. So if you were in that boat or you're curious how to make cooking easier for you or maybe even gathering or gardening, these three machines can be extremely helpful. But as another friendly reminder, it does use mist and it can be pretty hefty on the mist. It's pretty easy to lose track of how much mist you're using. I went from 44.8 to 43.3 because I just wanted to give you guys an example. It's not a huge loss, but over and over and over again, you'd be surprised how quickly that dwindles down to zero. So I hope that I was able to help you out today and give you any tips and tricks to assist. And I will be back next time with another tip and trick. See you later. Bye.